Rich with Mustang Connection. Thanks for stopping by. I am at Thermal Race Club in Thermal, California. This is a place, a private racetrack. Today is a Nitto tire event, and behind me are three of Classic Recreation's cars. He brought, Jason Engel brought out four. Thanks for watching. See y'all soon. All right, guys, check out this 1967 GT500CR. This is a Classic Recreations build. I'm with the owner, Jeff Miller. I'm going to introduce him here in a second. We're going to go around his black Shelby continuation by Classic Recreations. Anyhow, this thing is amazing. And we got a chance to see it on the track today. In fact, I have a little video of us behind it on the track. It's just a really cool car. Motivated by a 427 stroked Windsor. It's pro charged, it's got a 6-speed, but I'm gonna let Jeff kind of walk around it and talk about it and introduce him right now. Jeff, you want to come on up and say hello?
Hello, Rich. Hello, everyone.
Jeff, where are we at today? We are at
in Thermal Raceway Club in the east of Palm Springs, California.
This is Thermal, California.
Thermal, California.
I know. This beautiful facility, which I'll show you guys a little bit of video, but amazing. So we got some track time. Jeff not only owns this car, he owns another red one, the one that I featured not that long ago, a GT500, a 67 GT500, more of the traditional look, not the Eleanor style.
The classic model.
Classic model. Yep. Beautiful car, or the red one. So let's walk around this one, talk about it.
900S model. So the 900S model comes with Pro Charger, 427 Windsor block. It obviously has an upgraded interior, suspension and brakes are a little heavier duty. This car I opted for the Detroit Speed suspension because I intended to track it as well as drive it on the street. The car I ordered it in November of 2016. It's been finished since December of 2017. Originally came with a 5-speed gearbox, and I've modified it since to 6-speed. It has hydraulic clutch, 389 rear gears, all the power you want at all times. It's very, very streetable, yet very fast and very fun on the track.
And this one has a package shelf in the back, has a rear seat delete.
Rear seat delete because the wheels are tubbed, so it runs 335 tires in the
rear. Let's take a look, yep. It's got a huge wheel and tire package on it.
Right. So 15-inch rotors, 6-piston Wilwood brakes, plenty of stopping power with the Hydro Boost that we run off the power steering system.
Has side exit exhaust that does function.
Side exit functioning exhaust.
And these are functioning as well, right? The do they cool the brakes in the rear?
Yes. The B-Cool radiator system in, set up, dual fans. Never any problems with overheating. It's cold air conditioning. Full power, so all the conveniences of a modern car with the look of the old school.
It's got a Detroit Speed front end, correct? And a rear.
Front and rear. Yeah. Pan hard bar. Rear suspension, everything fully adjustable, coilovers, you see the shock towers are gone. Fully adjustable shocks all the way around it.
It's just, and these are in the registry, as you can see
it
here.
It's a real Shelby in the registry. Started life as a Ford Mustang, and still is.
Started life as a little 289 car, but look at it now. It's amazing.
Look at her now.
It's beautiful.
What I love about Jason is his attention to detail. Jason Engel is the owner of Classic Recreations. Paintwork is phenomenal. Fit and finish is great. He's built enough of these cars, over 200 of them, shipped them all over the world, and he's always making improvements to the engineering, and he builds them for the person who wants to drive them and enjoy them.
So I have to say, Jeff is a very, very generous, magnanimous owner. This car and the red car were tracked today. I mean, we're not just talking once or twice. They've been around the track a bunch of times. Never once did I see him hover over the cars or say, watch this or watch that. Jeff is an enthusiast. He loves cars. He owns a lot of different cars. I want to go through the list, but it's impressive because we don't want to make it sound like bragging, but it's a pretty kick-ass list. No. How about that? And maybe I'll cover some more of them in the future. But no, honestly, this is, you know, it's a great car. Now look, people are going to say, wow, that's so expensive. It is, but you get what you pay for. And honestly, Jason does deliver on the product. A lot of people will take your money. And, you know, as we were talking earlier, I just had a nice chat with Jeff about the process and everything. 12 months later, you get your car. Possibly getting...
There might be one
of those. Yeah, one or two of those coming. So
yeah.
I think you'll see more of Jeff's cars in the future on the channel. We're going to start it up, and I'll probably just cruise around with him real quick here because I did not get a ride in this car earlier. But like I said, I've driven his red car. He was gracious enough to let Con Media have that car for, gosh, a couple of months and stuff. And he's, to his credit, he's only had the cars finished and done for, I mean, not a very long time, a few months, and they're here. They're here at the track event because that shows you how much he believes in classic recreations and supporting Jason. So big shout out to Nitto Tires today. They provided all the tires that got scrubbed off pretty good today. The car looks incredible. And I've done, again, as usual, I end up doing most of the talking, but Jeff, anything else you want to add? I mean, just about your overall, I mean.
I would tell you my experience was fantastic. I've built cars before. You always think I can build one cheaper myself. That's never happened for me because you're always having budget overruns or you always add this or that. And, you know, for those of you who think it's a high price to pay, it's not. Quite honestly, these cars are a great bargain for the effort that goes into building.
Right.
3,000 hours of effort to build one of these cars. The other thing is, I'll tell you, you will not find these cars for sale used. People hold on to them, they hold their value.
So. I mean, you can see here, look at the body lines and stuff, and the car does have really nice lines. I mean, if you look at the gaps.
Is it functional on these?
Yes. Yes. It would have to because there isn't one back here anymore.
Back. Absolutely nothing in the back.
And, the exhaust is side exit only on this, right? There's it's not like a cutout
right,
type thing.
On the classic model, my red car, it's rear exit.
It is.
Okay.
Yes. Yeah.
Gives you a little different noise.
Even in here, look at this, you guys. It's finished. See that? That's got a textured finish in here. That's not just like left. But this gets a much taller console to fit that six-speed. Carroll Shelby sign dash. Just beautiful in here. I'm always impressed that they can get the aftermarket stuff to fit so well. Especially that stainless, it's not the easiest stuff to work with.
Yes.
This does have shaved drip rails. You'll notice there are no drip rails on this. That's a little touch, but I'm gonna have them cruise me around real quick. It's just a badass car. This thing will wake you up. Let me tell you, when this thing's rumbling and running, it's pretty impressive.
So 780, 790,
960 horsepower, I guess. This is all. Pretty trick.
Have your choice of colors.
Yeah. You know, this is tall, but this doesn't look out of place. I know it's big, but it doesn't feel big.
No.
I'm talking about
the console.
The custom console they have to make for it. Yeah.
Set up on it. It's got 389s in the rear on that.